हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम टू 11 टू 12 ई लर्निंग यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ आवर कॉलेज प्रताप विद्या मंदिर चोपड़ा एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग अ वेरी स्कोरिंग अ वेरी सिंपल टॉपिक एंड दैट टॉपिक इज ईमेल राइटिंग. This topic is very important for you because it is very simple and it is one of the most important communicative skill that you will use in your personal life also. Because nowadays so many people are using internet and email writing is called as one of the fastest way of communication. Now, first of all, what do you mean by email writing? Email means electronic mail. Now, mail means, in another words, we can call it as a letter. For example, we write a letter, go to the post office, post the letter, then after 5 or 6 days, the receiver of the letter receives our letter. And email means electronic mail, means by using the facility of internet, you type a mail. A mail means a type of letter, and send it, and within few seconds, the email reaches to the receiver. Receiver means the person whom you want to give this email, whom you want to reach this email to. The person you want to send the email to, he is called as a receiver. Okay. So, in letter writing, we have seen that there are two types of letters, formal and informal. These are the two main types. And some of the letters are semi-formal also. Even in email writing, here we have the two types. These two types are, one is formal, another is informal. In board question paper of 12th English, question number 4, section A, you have two options. One is letter writing, another is email writing. And I feel that email writing is comparatively more simple and more scoring for you. Again, this question, in question number 4, section A, only formal letters and formal email writing, this communicative skill will be asked to you. So let us concentrate on formal email writing. Okay, I hope that everybody of you understanding me. I am very slow, I am very steady. Now, I will give you the one question. Question of formal email writing. So what is the question? Your college is celebrating 104th anniversary. Prepare an email to invite the chief officer of municipal office of your town. Now your college is celebrating 104th anniversary, and as a chief guest, you want to invite the chief officer of municipal corporation or municipal office to your college. So you are sending him the invitation by email. So how will you prepare that email? Okay. Now let us move to the board. So when you are preparing or when you are writing an email, first of all, make a bracket. Maybe by using pencil, maybe by using the pen. And when you prepare this bracket, don't close the lower section, because when you are writing the email, you don't know how many lines will you write and you will continue your email. So don't close the lower part. First of all, when you prepare an email, there are the three steps. The first three steps, very easy. So remember this first three steps. Number one, from. It is very important that who is writing the email and what is his email address. For example, in letter writing, we write the self address. In email writing, your own email address should be written here. So actually, when you compose an email, compose. So if you open your mobile, open your laptop, computer, and start composing an email, and if you have the email account, in this section your email address is already typewritten, but in board exam nobody is going to give you a ready-made written email address. So you will have to write your own email address, that is from. Now, how will you write your email address? So that is also very important skill. Very easy. For example, my email address is, yogesh.shilan@gmail.com. You will say, sir, for Jogesh you should write J as a capital. So remember, friends, while writing an email address, there are no capital letters. And this email address is unique in all over the world. You will not find the same email address of any other person. So, Jogesh.Shela. So this is my name. And I have used the sign dot here. After writing my name, I have used this sign at. This is a very specific, this is very, what we say, a distinguished sign that is always used in writing the email address. At jogesh.shela@gmail.com. Now there are the various websites that provide you the facility of email writing. One of them is Gmail, another is Yahoo, third one is Reddit Mail, and etc. There are so many websites that provide the facility of email writing. So here I have chosen gmail.com. Now this is also the word you are quite familiar to, .com. Okay, now in board question paper, how will you write your email address? You will write it as ABC, because you are not going to enclose, you are not going to disclose your name. So you will write here ABC at. Now at is the sign. And another name of the website, yahoo.com. ABC at yahoo.com. So this is the email address of the sender. Who is sending the email? Easy? Understanding me? Okay. Now next two. Receiver, the person you want to send your email to. Two. What is his email address? For example, XYZ, that is his name. @gmail.com. This is another website, gmail.com. Now here we have seen the two steps. First of all, you have framed a bracket. In the beginning you are writing from. In that bracket you are, so in that new bracket from you are writing your own email address. What is that email address? abc@yahoo.com. Second step, the person you want to send your mail to is called as a receiver. You are writing his email address at xyz@gmail.com. The third important thing, now remember letter writing, your own address means self address, then addressee, then subject. Now here you will notice that, sir, my efforts are saved here. I can write the email address, I don't need to write the self address. I can save my time, I can save my energy. And this is very useful also, this is very interesting also. So comparatively I feel that email writing is more easy, more interesting than letter writing. And I think in future people will forget to write the letters. Most of the communication will be made in the format of email only. Okay, now subject. So what is the subject? For example, you are preparing an email and that email is an invitation. So you can say that an invitation for the 104th anniversary of the college. Okay. So and you are inviting the person as the chief guest. You are inviting the person as the chief guest. Okay, again I will again read it. An invitation for the 104th anniversary of the college as the chief guest. So that is what we say the subject of our email. Revise it from abc@yahoo.com to xyz@gmail.com. Again, there is the subject. Now, the subject is over. After the subject, there is what we say is the salutation. Even while writing letter, you may remember salutation. Dear sir, honorable sir, respected sir, respected madam, honorable madam. So these are the words that we normally use. Now here we will start our mail. So that is, we can see here is the salutation. HONOURA. Honorable sir, that is what we say the salutation. Honorable sir, that is what we say the salutation. After salutation, there is the body of the email. In body of the email, you will discuss the subject in detail. Okay, now here after that, I will share an image on it. I will, so that you can get the clear picture, you can easily understand it, and what you say, you can easily read it even on the small screen of your mobile. Now from here I start sharing the picture and read the email that I have prepared. Okay, so in that new bracket from you are writing your own email address. What is that email address? abc@yahoo.com. Second step, the person you want to send your mail to is called as a receiver. You are writing his email address at xyz@gmail.com. The third important thing. Now remember, letter writing. Your own address means self address, then addressee, then subject. Now here you will notice that, sir, my efforts are saved here. I can write the email address. I don't need to write the self address. I can save my time. I can save my energy. And this is very useful also. This is very interesting also. So comparatively, I feel that email writing is more easy, more interesting than letter writing. And I think in future, people will forget to write the letters. Most of the communication will be made in the format of email only. Okay, now, subject. So what is the subject? For example, you are preparing an email and that email is an invitation. So you can say that an invitation for the 104th anniversary of the college. Okay. So, and you are inviting the person as the chief guest. You are inviting the person as the chief guest. Okay, again, I will again read it. An invitation for the 104th anniversary of the college as the chief guest. So, that is what we say, the subject of our email. Revise it from abc@yahoo.com to xyz@gmail.com. Again, there is the subject. Now, the subject is over. After the subject, there is what we say is the salutation. Even while writing letter, you may remember salutation. Dear sir, honorable sir, respected sir, respected madam, honorable madam. So these are the words that we normally use. Now here we will start our mail. So that is, we can see here is the salutation. HONOURA. Honorable sir, comma. That is what we say the salutation. Honorable sir. That is what we say. The salutation. After salutation, there is the body of the email. In body of the email, you will discuss the subject in detail. Okay, now here after that I will share an image on it. I will, so that you can get the clear picture, you can easily understand it, you can easily read it even on the small screen of your mobile. Now from here I start sharing the picture and read the email. So friends, and now see the shared image of email writing of formal type. Here you can see from abc at yahoo.com to means the sender's address xyz@gmail.com. Subject: an invitation for the 103rd anniversary program of the college. Now, as it is a formal letter, we will have to write the address of the addressee. Now, who is our addressee? The chief officer, comma, municipal office, comma, Chopra. Now, here you can see the body of the email. Honorable sir, this is what we say, the salutation. Honorable sir, comma. Now, the first paragraph. On 9th of January 2021, we are going to celebrate 103rd anniversary of our college. It is our pleasure and pride to invite you as the chief guest of the program. You are appointed as the chief officer of the municipal office. You have appeared for the various competitive exams and you are an excellent orator. So this is the first paragraph. Now the ending paragraph. Our students will certainly get inspiration from your speech and valuable guidance from your experience in competitive exam. Last closing paragraph. Kindly accept our invitation, sending you the invitation card in attachment. Now, every email has the facility of attachment where you can attach the file. Now here you will attach the soft copy of the invitation card and send it to the chief officer of municipal office, means the person whom you are going to invite. Okay, now the last word, it is regards. Sometime you write thanking you, here you are writing regards. Now the body of the letter is over. Now at the end part, you are giving the designation of the sender, who is sending this formal email. So that's why at the end part, the designation is also very important. The principal, PVM Junior College, Chopra. Now here, when you write the principal, in the T is capital. In the word principal, P is capital, comma, PVM Junior College, comma, Chopra. Now in this way, you can end your email. Okay, so slowly and steadily, I have explained you the whole, the complete method of writing an ideal formal email. Now, you can practice with some more examples. Maybe in the next session, we will be with some more examples. And I hope that you may have understood the email writing skill. Thank you very much.